So, yesterday we were discussed about the emission gain as well as the entropy. Entropy will help us to measure the uncertainty or impurity of the data. If entropy reaching towards the one, that means it is a pure node or impure node. It is a impure node. If entropy reaching towards the zero, that means a pure node. Entropy will not help us to split the attribute or variable, but it will help us to split the levels of a variable. To measure the best split of a variable or best attribute to choose, for that we are going to use the information gain. What do you mean by information? Information gain is nothing but how much amount of message we are getting from that variable. That is called as the information. How do we calculate the information gain? Entropy at the root node minus sum of weighted entropy at each child node. To measure that, we are going to use the information gain. We discussed all these things yesterday. The major step of the algorithm is to identify the best split variable and best split criteria. That means we have a thousands of variable. Out of thousand variable, which variable I need to consider as the first variable? Even yesterday, if you remember, when we do the business small 14 records data, where we need to predict whether customer will order the product or not based on the gender and marital status, as we have taken the first variable as a gender variable and marital status as a second variable. We have raised a one question. Why did we consider the gender variable as a first variable? Why don't we consider as a marital status as a second variable? We said we need to raise the question. Now, how do we choose? Do I need to consider the marital status first, or do we need to consider the gender variable first? Based on the information gain, we will consider. Wherever information gain is high for the of two variables, either gender variable or marital status, that variable will come into as a first variable, and then the remaining variable will come into the second variable. And here we have to follow the five different steps. First, select a leaf node. Leaf node means first we have a root node, we don't have any nodes. That is the child node also will call as a leaf node. That means select a node, leaf node, and select the attribute. Select the attribute is nothing but we have a thousands of variable. Wherever we have the best variable, select that variable. And in the variable, we might have the level, two level or a single level, three level, like that. If the single level, then we need to stop. We don't have any other option, right? For example, I have a variable which consists of only the country. In the country, only in the variable is a country. In the country, we have one variable, only one level. Assume that that is India. We don't have any other level. Do we need to go further with that? We cannot, right? We have only one level. We cannot calculate the information gain at that point. We cannot calculate the entropy at that point. We have to stop at the moment only. When you can able to calculate the information gain or entropy, if you have more than one level, then only you can able to calculate the information gain or entropy. If it is a only one level, we cannot calculate the information gain or entropy. When do I need to stop? Each leaf node contains example of only one type, the one which I have given. Algorithm ran out of variables. That means no further variables to do the analysis. Everything has been done. No further significant of information. If the information we are getting 0, 0.1, 0.2, 1, in that case, it doesn't make sense. Automatically, it will stop it. Now, let's do a one example. Here, while building the decision tree algorithm, we need to follow the various steps. First one is select a leaf node. Select a leaf node means first we select any attribute. From the attributes, we need to select the best attribute. Best attribute is nothing but the attribute which is giving the maximum information gain. Split that node using the attribute. Whatever the attribute is selecting, that node we need to split. How do you split? Based on the entropy, we need to split, and we need to do the remaining process for all the variable. Now let's go with one example, like the same way which you have done the example yesterday. 14 record, we have the gender variable, we have the marital status, order the product. Even I raised the question yesterday, which variable I need to consider. Yesterday we considered the gender variable. We may get a doubt, why we have considered gender variable, why don't we consider the marital status? Randomly I consider the first variable gender. Even I don't know at this point. Now I need to calculate. First, as per the algorithm steps we discussed, first we need to select the leaf nodes. Here the two leaf nodes, gender as well as the marital status. First, for the two variables, based on the two variables, we need to select the attribute. How do we select the attribute? Based on the information gain, we need to select the attribute. Wherever the information gain is high, for that variable, we can consider as the first variable. Here, in this case, gender, we have the, in the gender, we have the total 14 customers. Out of that, total 14 customers, out of that, total 14 customer, out of that, one customers will be total 14 customer. Out of this, we have the 4 customers are buying the product and 10 customers are not buying the product. In the gender wise, there are the M and total 8 males and 6 females. Out of 6-8 males, 7 are not buying the product, 1 are buying the product. In the female, we have the 3 products are buying, 3 products are not buying. Whereas in the same case, gender, marital status, married or unmarried, we have the married customers are 9 and unmarried customers are 5. Now, first what we need to do as per the algorithm, select the two leaf nodes. How many leaf nodes we have? We have the two leaf nodes, right? Gender and married. In the two leaf nodes, we need to select the best attribute. How do we select the best attribute? Based on the information gain, we will select the best attribute. What do you mean by information gain? Information gain is giving us the how much amount of information or message stored in that variable. That is called as information gain. In the formula for the information gain is entropy at the root node minus sum of entropy at each child node. Sum of entropy at each child node. In this case, what we are going to do, we are calculating the entropy for the gender is, information gain for gender is 12.4. Information gain for the marital status is 60.5. Now, which variable will come into the first variable? Marital status. Marital status will come into the first variable. Okay. See, here the information gain for the marital status is high. So, it has to be the first variable. Now, we have the information gain. Total number of records. We have marital status. Married or unmarried. Now, I need to select the married or unmarried. Do I need to select the married or unmarried or both? No, we are not going to select the both. Wherever entropy is less, that is going to be your root node. Where, for example, your marital status, your married or unmarried, does married is going to be your root node, or does unmarried is going to be your root node? Wherever entropy is less, that part is going to be your leaf node. So go back to the here in the married and unmarried, right? Wherever entropy is less, married or unmarried? Married. So you are going to start under the married customers. We have the male and female. That is the algorithm diagram. So we are going to stop the unmarried over there only. We are not going to do further with the unmarried customers. Is it clear? Let me repeat again. If you want to build the decision tree models, first point we need to remember that we need to select the leaf nodes. Leaf nodes is nothing but select the all the attributes. While selecting the all the attributes, what we need to do, we have to choose the all the variables wherever the attribute which is the maximum information gain, that variable as a first variable. Based on that we need to do the split. Here also we are choosing the marital status as well as gender. We have a two variables. Out of that, marital status is the high information gain, so we are going to consider the marital status as a first variable. Here now where I need to start again, we have a two levels. Do I need to start under the married or do I need to start under the unmarried? Wherever, how do, I cannot choose the root nodes both, right? Either one only I can choose the root node. Always root node will be the only one. So which one I need to choose as a root node? The best fundamental is wherever entropy is less, that part we need to choose the root node. And again we need to start the same process. Is everyone is clear? Guys, is everyone is clear who are on the call? Any doubt about how do we choose all this thing? Because it is a fundamental important point. If you have doubt about this, please let me know. I will explain.
No code, can you please repeat? Sorry.
Do you want me to repeat? Giri, do you want me to repeat?
Yes, code. Yes.
Here, if you want to follow the decision tree algorithm, we need to follow the some set of rules. First, always your root node will be first starting initial case. Always your root node will be your dependent variable. That will be fine. Once we choose the dependent variable, select a leaf node. Select a leaf node is nothing but select the all the information, all the attributes. Once we select the all the attributes, from the select group of the attributes, we need to select the best attribute. What do you mean by best attribute? The attribute which is giving the maximum information gain. That attribute we can choose as a best information gain. Based on the best information gain attribute, we need to choose the, you know, split the data. While splitting the data, let's say if you are going with an example here, we have a two variables, we are selecting gender and marital status. Wherever we have the, which is the highest information gain? Does the gender is having the highest information gain or does the marital status is the highest information gain? Based on the here, compare when you do this thing, marital status is having the highest information gain. So what we are going to do, we are going to consider the marital status, marital status as the first variable. So here we have mentioned the marital status. Now we have under the marital status, we have two levels, married and unmarried. Do I need to consider the married or do I need to start with the unmarried or do I need to start with the both? Always while choosing the root node, it will be only one. How do I choose? Wherever entropy is less, that point we can choose. Here in this case, entropy is less for the under the marital status, entropy is less for the married customer. So what we are going to do, we are going to start with the married customer. Married customer further. In this case, married and then repeating the best splitting attribute. Okay. And then we need to stop it. That is the meaning. Is it clear now?
It's good. Clear.
Now, how many levels we have discussed so far? We are discussing only two levels. What if I have more than two levels? I have more than two levels. Let's say we have a population. Under the population, we have a income information gain. Here we have a very low, medium, high, and very high. What happens? In this case, how do I choose? While building the fundamental rule is, while building the information, it should not have more than three nodes in a particular variable. Maximum three. Some cases, in worst scenario, it can be four. If it is a four, the model is going to be deteriorated. It is not giving the good results. Up to three only, it will give the good results. The reason is that if the more than three nodes, splitting the data will be very high. It is a concentration population will be very, very small. That is the reason model is going to be deteriorated. The reason you may get the confusion. What do you mean by deteriorated? All these things that it doesn't give a good accuracy. That is the meaning of deteriorate. You may get splitting the data means, let's say if I split the five nodes here, for example, in the population 1000 records, assume that very low is the 100 records, low is the 200 records, medium are 300 records, high is the 200 records, very high is the 200 records. Let's say assume that out of five records, maybe entropy is high for the low for the medium. Assume that. Which one I need to consider? Wherever entropy is low, that part only we need to consider. So in the medium, assume that medium is having the low entropy. That going to be act as a root node. Yes. So here, I'm going to consider only the medium. So what is the population out of 1000 records? How many records I'm going to consider? 200 records. That means 80% of the data I'm going to lose it. So that is the reason while building the model, make sure that it should have three nodes. So the splitting of the data will be very less. So we are going to use the medium. High or very high. Now in this case, what we need to do? First of all, calculate the bad rate for all the groups. Very low, low, medium, high and very high. First of all, what do you mean by bad rate? Bad rate is nothing but number. You have a dependent variable, number of ones divided by total number of records. For example, bad rate is nothing but you have a dependent variable. Always you are trying to predict the one only. That means bad rate is nothing but our event rate. We can call also, some people will call as a event rate or target ratio or bad rate. Here in this case, bad rate is the formula is number of ones divided by total number of records. For example, you have a 10,000 records total. Out of that, bad rate is the 1000 records for the one. So 1000 divided by 10,000. So how much it will be? 10%. That is the meaning of the bad rate. What is the bad rate for very low income? What is the bad rate for low? Let me give you an example so that you can easily understand. Here, let's say I have four nodes. S1, node 1, basically S2, S3. Yes, for okay, node basically node 1, node 2, node 3. S means node. Here 8%, 10%, 9%, 12%. Okay, this is the bad rate. Your bad rate is nothing but number of bads divided by total number of records. That means number of bads is nothing but number of ones divided by total number of bad rate is nothing but number of bads. That is nothing but number of ones divided by total. Here we have the bad rate for S1 is the 8%, S2 is the 10%, S3 is the 9%, S4 is the 12%. So while choosing the nodes, let's say you have a 4 nodes or 5 nodes for a variable, let's say income variable, we have the 5 nodes. Low income, medium income, very low income, like that. We have the 5 nodes. While choosing that, the make sure point will be, It need to be in a monotonicity. Monotonicity means either purely increasing order or it is decreasing order. Monotonicity means it is purely in increasing order or decreasing order. Monotonicity and increase either an increasing order or monotonicity means it purely increasing order or decreasing, it is purely increasing order. So here 8%, 10%, 9, 12. Is it increasing order? No, right? It is failing here in this case, right? This or it is in decreasing order? No, again it is failing. So in this case, what we need, where the point is failing, where the point it is failing. Which is the near point? Does the 10 is near or does the 12 is near? 10 is near, so we need to take the average. So S1, S2 and S3 one group. S4 is the one group. Let's say 8, 10 plus 9 is 9.5, 12. Is it increasing order now? That is how we will do the finalization. So here, wherever it is breaking, that point we need to, which is the nearest value, the either left side or right side, it can be also. Take the average of these 2 points, club the group, and we can have a maximum 3 nodes also, no problem at all. Okay, that is how we follow. Yes, instead of 10, assume that it is a 7, then we need to select 7, 8. Let's take the another example. Let's say now 7 here, in this case left side, right? 8 is a near point. So S1 and S2 is the one group, that is 7, 8 and 7.5. S3 is the 10. S4 is the
Cody, one small question. See, in this case S1 we can keep it like that, and S2 S3 can we make it as a group? Because average it will come as 8.5 something, right?
But here in this case, always we need to show, take care the background, how it is work. Whatever the value which is the decaying, I mean the order which is breaking, after 8 it should be 9 or 10 like that. But it's 7. The point 7 is only breaking, right? So in that point, the value which is near to that point only we need to consider. 7, for the 7, the nearest value is 8, not the 10.
Okay, that is
the what we are going to do here in the here. That is what we have taken the various examples, and we have created finally three things. We have created the finally three things, and again we repeat the same process. Lab. Now we would like to do a one lab decision tree building. Now how do we, and we calculate the information gain, we calculated the information gain, we check the many number of attributes into three. No need to do all these things manually. System automatically it will give the output. Just we are at a position to able to analyze it. We are in a position, are we able to analyze the data? That is what we are going to do. In interview point of view, they might ask you what is information gain and entropy, how the background is. That you have to tell what you have discussed so far from yesterday onwards. You have to tell. But while executing the program or decision tree in the real time, no need to worry about this. Automatically it will give. Just you need to write the one line syntax code. Here we are going to import the data. We are going to e-custom survey. In that, how many customers are participating in the survey? How do we get to know how many customers are there? By using DIM function. Overall, most of the customers are dissatisfied or satisfied. We need to understand. So we need to predict whether customers are satisfied or unsatisfied. Can you segment the data and find the concentrate satisfied or dissatisfied? What are the major characteristics of satisfied customers, or what are the major characteristics of dissatisfied customers? If you tell about the one thing, dissatisfied customers or satisfied customer, we can get easily about the others. Here for this, we are going to use the R part. The package name as well as the function name also the same. R part only. We need to install the R part. In the R part, what we are going to do, formula. Formula is nothing but here in the formula, let me show you this thing. Here in the formula, the first one, the formula is y tilde x1 plus x2 plus x3. Y is nothing but dependent variable. Tilde x1, x2, x3 means independent variable. Method is equal classification tree. So if your dependent variable is binary, in this case we mention the method is equal class. For example, if your dependent variable is continuous, continuous means linear regression, multiple linear regression. In this case, we need to mention method is equal to ANOVA. For controlling the tree means in each node, how many number of records should be there? Minimum number of record. Okay, how many number of CP minimum split is nothing but minimum number of records in each node. Minimum split is nothing, minimum number of observation in a node, 30 before attempting the split. Before applying the split, how many records should be there? Minimum at least. It can be maximum anything, but minimum number of records only. 0.001 is nothing but that is a CP value, that is a complexity parameter, that is nothing but it will control the tree growth size. How do we use that? We can discuss that in detail. Okay, let's do a one lab and then after we are going further with the ANOVA me. ANOVA me. One second, I'll explain. ANOVA means, method is equal to ANOVA means, if a dependent variable is a continuous variable, then we can use the method is the ANOVA. Tell me, Giri. Hello?
When you were explaining, you gave some numbers, right? 8, 7, 12, 15, like that. How you are giving that number?
Randomly given that number to understand your process, that is even given the numbers. Just as an example, I show how the backend.
Okay, what is
it? Pardon?
Oh, what is those numbers?
Bad rates. Bad rate is nothing but the formula, that is a number of bads divided by total number of records. Randomly given as an example.
Number of bads is equal to number of ones. What is number of ones?
In your dependent variable, you have a 1 and 0. 1 is nothing but total number of ones. Number of bads is nothing but how many number of total count of the ones.
Okay.
We imported the data set. Data set consists of 11812 with 7 observation. DIM of the data set, which consists of the 11812 names of e-custom survey. In the names of e-custom survey, we have the 7 variable. Those are the names, customer number, ID kind of thing. Region. Which region does the customer belongs to? Age of the customer. Order quantity. How many quantities he has? Order. Customer type. Prime customer. Improvement area where I need to sell. Focus. And overall satisfaction. Overall satisfaction. 1 means satisfied customer. 0 means non-satisfied customer. Here in this case, na.omit. If there are any na.omit, why we explain this function now? Na.omit, what does it will do? It will remove the entire row if there are any na values in a particular record. For example, assume that in the second row for the third variable, we have the na. So automatically it will remove the entire row. Automatically it will remove the entire row. To remove the entire row, if there are na values, we are going to use the na.omit. E custom survey is equal to MA, na.omit. Before we are removing the na.omit, how many records we have? 11,812. After removing the na.omit, how many records we have? 7 rows has been removed because of the na values. Use.na function is there. Now, if there are any na values, we cannot able to build the decision tree model. Not only any model we cannot build. Before we are building the model, we need to check. We need to impute all the missing values and outliers. Of course, we did all minimum. but we want to remove the NA value. Some point of time may get a question in interview also. So how do we remove? For the we try an example and data vomit. Now we are building the model library of rpart. Rpart means is a package ecom tree rpart overall satisfaction, that is a depend variable, region, age, order quantity, customer type, and customer number we did not select. The reason is the ID. IDs we cannot use into the model. And method is equal to class. Method is equal to class means our dependent variable is the binary. Data is equal to data set name. Control is equal to rpart.control. Minimum split is the 30. You can keep 20 also, you can keep the 10 also, or you can keep the 1 also, no problem at all. Minimum split is the 30. What does it mean? Before we are splitting the data, it should have minimum number of records will be 30. That is the meaning of the minimum. So let me explain the syntax again. Rpart is the package. Rpart is the function also. Rpart, first we need to write the depend variable. What is your depend variable? Overall satisfaction tilde region plus age comma order quantity customer type plus improvement area. Method is equal to class. Data is equal to ecustom survey. Control is equal to rpart.control. Minimum split is 30. Ecom tree. So here let me explain you the output here. Number of n is nothing but number of records. How many records you have? 1180. Node split, it has taken probability values, terminal node means leaf nodes, all these things happen. In the root node, in the root node means, as I mentioned clearly, in the first when you start the dependent decision tree, what is your root node? Your dependent variable will be your root node. As that we discussed? Yes. Okay. In the root, how many records we have total? 1180 5 1180 5. Let me show you the here. Let me with an example. Total root node will be out of that here zero, these many records which are the zero, and this is the percentage of zero percentage and percentage of ones and percentage of zeros. Here 537, after that they mentioned the zero. That means these many records which are the zeros, that means dissatisfied customers. Because in the root node we have a 0 and 1. They mentioned after number after 0. That means which records are related to 0. That means again here 0.54% one side, 0.46% one side. Again this is the 1 starting point, right? Next, what is the second and third? Second, order quantity. Order quantity less than 40, 0.5. Third is order quantity greater than 40.5. Already less than, this is the now. Which one we need to is the second, which one it is the third. Your first node is the root node is the one. Here does order quantity less than 40.5 is the second node, or does the order quantity greater than 40.5 is the third. Here in the second is the order quantity less than 40.5. Okay, that is the second one. As I mentioned here, the point first rule number one, rule number two. Now, so this will be second and this will be the order quantity greater than 45.5. Now, do I need to start the under the second or do I need to start under the third? How do I know? Here, it clearly they mention after 2, it is 4 and 5. After 2, it is 4 and 5. It is not the 3. That means it splits the data after 2, 4 and 5. That means split the data under the 2 and not under the 3. If they mention under the 3 values 4 and 5, then it splits the data under the 3. But here after 2 they mention 4 and 5. After the second rule they mention the 4th rule and 5th rule. They did not mention the 3rd rule. That means they are splitting the data under the second position, not the 3rd position. If they would have mentioned the under 3rd position, that means it splits the data under the third and under third. Age quantity greater than 45.5 29.5 or less than 29.5. This is the 4, this is the 5, this is the equation. Is everyone able to clear? How did we create? Pardon? Output? I'm open. Is everyone is clear? How do I write the draw the graph? 4 means those many records under the age greater than 20. Those many zeros are there. I mean that out of 7018, 648 are the zeros and remaining are the 1. That is 90% of the 1 and 0.909% are the zeros.
Koti, what is that star indicates? End of that 4th and 5th.
Where?
Here. In output 4 and 5, 4th and 5th point is there, right? And star is there.
Those are the leaf nodes. If star indicates here, can you see the output here also in the terminal node? Here star denotes the terminal node. Terminal node is nothing but leaf nodes, end nodes. In our output also, these are the leaf nodes. This one, and this one also leaf node. There is no further nodes. Those are called as the leaf nodes. There are no further nodes. Those are called as the leaf nodes.
Okay.
Here clearly it indicates, denotes the terminal node. Is it clear how I written the example? Is everyone is clear?
Koti, I have one.
Yeah.
So why we used the na.omit function? Why we not used impulse?
Impute. The reason.
Impute.
The reason why I use the na.omit. Ideally, we need to go with the impute only. We should not remove the records. But as an understanding point, I've used the na.omit. But in general cases, we need to go with the impute only. But in some point of time, they might ask me this kind of question also. So we are not considering the data, we just want to remove. That is the reason I given an example. But in all the cases, you need to input the data. That is true. But in interview point of view, questions, what they're asking, if there are any missing values of data, we should not consider those rows into our analysis. We need to remove those records, those rows entirely. In that case, how do we write the program? To write that program, we are using na.omit. Na.omit means if there are any missing values in a particular record, automatically it will remove entire row, entire observation.
Okay.
That is the meaning.
I have one question. So to build that decision tree, the dependent variable will always be like binary data, or is there any more any other data, like not one or zero, like anything?
Yes, we can also use the continuous data. As I mentioned, right, if you mention method is equal class, that means it will take the binary dependent variable. If your dependent variable is continuous variable, then we can use the method is equal ANOVA.
So before starting this model, we need to check the duplicate values and outliers also, or there is no need to check those functions?
Yes, while building the model, you need to do all these things in a project. Just now, as of now, we are just doing a lab to learn a particular algorithm. Our main focus is to the missing values and outliers as of this point. But definitely when you are doing a particular project, are building a model in the real time, before you are building the model, you need to ensure that it does not have any missing values or any outliers.
Okay.
But here in this case, just as a building algorithm only, learning the algorithm point, right? We're not main focusing into the missing values and outliers.
Okay, I understand.
Okay.
Thank you.
Now, everyone is clear how I read the now. We written the graph in the manual. Now we need to draw that graph by using the R. How do I write? Plot the trees. Plot ecom tree. Uniform. Uniform means all the nodes should be there. Uniform is equal true means all the nodes should be there. Just it is a tree format. Test. We have got this one right. Nothing is there. Right? We need to write the text in that. We need to include the text in that. Text ecom tree. Use dot n. Use dot n means total number of observation. N means total number of observation. All is equal to. All means all the point, all the nodes. Use the as much as possible information. Whatever we have in the ecom tree. That is the meaning of this one. If I use that, does it make any sense? For me, it is not making any sense. To make the sense, we are going to use the graphical representation. How do we form the graphical representation? To form the graphical representation, library is equal to Rattle is the one package. Rattle is the one package. Fancy R part. There is a function called fancy R part. Ecom tree. Ecom tree is the whatever we have assigned. Platelets, that means node type and node color will be gray or red. You can keep red, yellow, blue, white, anything you can keep. Platelet is nothing but nodes. See now how it is running. See, this is what we got it. This is the total population out of the zeros, whatever the 0% is, 54%. And it has considered order quantity 2 and here 3. 3 means 1 sub pop. And A is greater than 29.5 rounded as into 30. 0 sub. This is the whatever the example exactly we create. This is how it create. In the final, it will give the output this, like this. You need to able to analyze. This is the output. It clearly indicates that 59% of the customers here. 59% of the customer where is here first see. Does it focus in 0 or 1? 0. Here it clearly the box as indicated 0. 0 means satisfied customer or dissatisfied customer. Satisfied customer. Dissatisfied customer. Sorry. 0 means dissatisfied customer. As I mentioned, always we are making the decisions by using the leaf nodes. What is the leaf nodes here? Here A is greater than 30. This is the 0 means 59% of the customer where A is greater than 30 and order quantity less than 40 customers are most of them are dissatisfied customers. Here no means opposite where 37% of the satisfied customer 37% of order greater than 40 customers, order less than 40 customers are satisfied. Where order quantity greater than 40 and as well as is greater than or equal to 30, those are 59% of the total customers are dissatisfied. 37% of the customers are satisfied and order quantity is greater than 40. So less than 40. Here less than 40, right? This is the less than 40. Huh? That means not ordering the product. No means not the right one. Two third, right? That is the 3 means. Is everyone is clear?
Forward quantity less than 50, left
shade.
Forward quantity less than 50. Left shade.
Order quantity?
Less than 50.
Less than 50.
50.
Where is 50?
40.
Ah.
In left
side. That is the meaning of this one. Now, this is the graph. Of course, this is the final output. How do we get the order quantity first? Based on the information gain. How do you split this based on the entropy value? It split. We doesn't require to calculate manually. Now we need to validate the model equation. E-cust survey, that is a custom survey. Ecom predict ecom tree type is equal class. type is equal to class means automatically it will give the 1 and 0. If I mention type is equal to prob, that means it will give the C. Here the automatically it gives the incomplete 0 and 1. For example, if I mention the type is equal to probability, automatically it is giving the probability value 90.07, like that. Here the mainly focus into the dissatisfied customers, right? So that is the reason 0 giving the dissatisfied customers. Now how do we validate that model? How do we get the accuracy? How do we get the accuracy of the model? To measure the accuracy of the model, we need to use the confusion matrix. To draw the or to construct the confusion matrix, what are the variables we require to construct the confusion matrix? We require the two variables. Those are dependent, actual dependent variable, predicted variable. Here confusion matrix table of e-custom survey, overall satisfaction is a dependent variable. E-custom survey, e-com pred. Pred means automatically converted into 0 and 1. And accuracy of the model is 94 times we can able to classify the satisfied customer as satisfied customers and dissatisfied customer as dissatisfied customer. Only the remaining 5% of the customers or 6% of the whatever the remaining percentage, those many customers we are not able to concentrate focus perfectly. That is the meaning of the one. Let me repeat again. First, we are building the model. We doesn't worry about the information gain, all this thing. Automatic system will take care about that. It will give a graph. Based on that graph or plot, we just need to measure the accuracy of the model. What is the accuracy? To measure the accuracy, we require the two things. One is your actual dependent variable that will be available with the data. We need to go with the predicted variable. To predict a variable, we need to predict whatever the model we are passing, model 1 or model 2, comma type is equal to, if I mention type is equal to class, automatically it will convert 1 and 0. If you mention the type is equal to probability, it will give the probability values. It will give the probability value. Now, based on that, we need to draw the confusion matrix. Based on the confusion matrix, we will measure the accuracy. We will measure the accuracy. And any question so far? That is how we build the decision tree in the R. Of course, the same way we are building the decision tree in the Python or SAS also. But how do we use this? Now we need to understand what could be happen what could happen? For example, what is the minimum split we kept? 30. We split the minimum split as a 30 in this case. Yeah. Minimum split is here in this case. We mentioned the minimum split is 30. That means in each and every node, before splitting the node, in each and every node, it must have to have the at least 30 records, then only it can go ahead and split the node. If there are any in the worst scenario, if there are less than 30 variables, it doesn't split the data. That is what the meaning of the minimum split. For example, what happens if I given the minimum split as 1? The number of leaf nodes will increase. Here the leaf nodes, this is less than 30, these are the leaf nodes. If I mention the leaf nodes also will increase. If leaf nodes increase, the strategy or the equation will be very difficult to draw. How does it perform the accuracy of the model? For that, we are going to import the two methods, two data sets. From text, we are importing the one data set. Train data, I am importing the train data set. Train train. In the train data, we have only the 14 records. Age, gender, birth. I need to validate that model also. So I am importing the test data also. In the test data, we imported it consists of only 6 records. See how we are building the model. Yeah, R part library, R part I am building the model. Sample tree, R part bot. Here in the train data set, we have the bot. Yes or no, we have that is the bot. We need to, based on the age and gender, we need to predict whether customer will buy the product or not. Bot tilde gender plus age. Method is equal to class. Data is equal to train. Control is equal to R part dot control. Minimum split is the 2. That means in the particular node, it should be minimum number of records are the 2. Even you can keep, if you want, you can keep the 1 also. No problem. 0, but we cannot. At least 1 record should be there, right? 0 records, it doesn't make sense. Minimum split is the 1. Can I keep 1.5, 2.5? It doesn't possible, right? We can say first row, second row. We cannot say 1.5 rows. There is no make sense. We can keep the whole numbers only. 1, 2, 3, like that. Sample tree, see. How many records we have? Total 14 records. See. Number n is equal to 14 record. See how many rules it follows. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, 11, 6, 3, 12, 13, 14. That means for each and every row, it creates the one rule. For each and every record, it creates the one rule. So for 14 rows, it created the almost 13 rules. In 6 rows, in the validation while testing, 6 rows are there. Does it effectively works? No, right? It doesn't work effectively. So in this case, let's check the accuracy of the model. Let's plot the data. How does it work? See, even it will be really difficult to us understand or identify the data, because very, very small data. This is the first top node is the root node. These are the child nodes. Again, these are the child nodes. But child nodes, how many child nodes are there? 4 child nodes are there, 1 root node. But how many leaf nodes are there? 6 leaf nodes are there. If leaf nodes means this end portion, the end line, what are the, if leaf nodes are very high in the data, it may cause us the overfitting. What do you mean by overfitting? Your model may perform well on the training data set on a given data set, but it may fail on the validation data set. The difference accuracy between the training accuracy and validation accuracy is huge. The difference between the training accuracy and validation accuracy is far away, then we can say it is the overfitting model. In this case also, if the model has accuracy increases, I mean leaf nodes are increases, that means clearly when you look into the graph, by get to know the, as a experience, as from my experience, what I understood, if the number of leaf nodes are very high, I'm not doing any interpretation, anything, just by as a hard rule, what experience from the over the period of 6 years, if number of leaf nodes are increases, number of leaf nodes are increases, it clearly indicates that number of leaf nodes are more than your child node as well as a root node. Combining of your child node plus a root node, number of leaf nodes are very high. It clearly indicates that your model is overfitting model. That means your model is not performing well. What do you mean by overfitting? Your model is performing well on the training data set, not performing well on the validation data set. That is what the meaning of the overfitting. Clear? You may get that. For example, my accuracy in the training data set, I got 80%. let's say validation I got 75%. Can I say it is overfitting? No. If the difference between the training accuracy and validation accuracy more than 10% difference, then only we can say it is a overfitting. The difference between the overfitting means model has not built perfectly. Overfitting means model has not built perfectly. Model has not built perfectly. In most of the interview questions, they definitely are going to ask the question, what do you mean by overfitting? Most of the interview question, they are going to be asked the question, what do you mean by overfitting? The difference between the accuracy, training accuracy and validation accuracy is not good. It is more than 10% kind of thing. Then simply we can say it is a overfitting. In most of 99% of the cases, interview question, they are going to ask this question. So simply they might ask, while building a model, what are the problems you may get? The question might like this. While building the model, any model, logistic regression, decision tree, any model, or neural networks, any model, what are the problems you may get? The first problem we may get is the overfitting. They might ask you a question, what do you mean by overfitting? Overfitting means that the difference between the training accuracy and validation accuracy is more than 10%. Then we can say it is an overfitting model. That is what the meaning of the word. Everyone is clear, guys? Any questions? Now, I am checking the accuracy on the training data set. Predict sample tree we assigned. Sample tree, comma, type is equal to class. We are drawing the confusion matrix. So, and one means 100%. What does it mean? 100% of the time, we are able to classify buying the customer as buying customer, non-buying customer, not buying. But how your model is performing on the validation data set. That is the your validation data set, which we call as a test data set. Test pred. And the test, we are creating a new variable, test pred. Predict sample tree, comma, where we are applying on this test data. Type is equal to class. Here we are measuring the confusion matrix. 33%. What is the accuracy in the training data set? 100%. What is the accuracy in the validation data set? 33%. Is it good? It is not at all a good. In this case, how do I control the overfitting? To control the overfitting, we are going to use the CP value. CP value. How do we use the CP value? That we will discuss tomorrow. Point. Most of the cases while building the decision trees in real time also, why we are not preferring decision tree rather than logistic regression? Just we are not preferring the decision tree. Always prefer the logistic regression for the linear data. The reason is that there is a more probable chances decision tree is going to become as a overfitting model, because decision tree is depending on tree growth or control size of the minimum spread. If you are not focusing the minimum spread as well as the complexity parameter or growth of the tree or structure of the tree, automatically there will be more probable chances model is going to become as a overfit model. To overcome that, we are going to use the most of the case logistic regression. In interview point of view also, they might ask you, why don't you use the decision tree? Why do you use the logistic regression? The reason is that decision tree is more probable chances to become as overfitting model, because decision tree is not focusing initially into the size of the tree or growth of the tree or structure of the tree. But those kind of things will not arise in the logistic regression. So mainly we are focusing into the logistic, both linear data, decision tree only works for the linear data. It doesn't work for the non-linear data. That we will discuss in the later sessions. Guys, is it clear? Tomorrow we will see what is CP value, and then we'll go for the next topic tomorrow. Any questions, guys?